how much more do you think that moment meant, having sort of had your breakout year as a singles competitor, but basically almost exclusively inside the Thunderdome?
One of my fears was, and I was joking around with my friends, is like, hey, man, some of us might think, all right, we're over. We're hot in this Thunderdome. And you think, all right, it's going to be a breeze once we get in front of people. But in the back of my mind, I low-key worry, like, man, maybe I get out there and it's crickets. Maybe people aren't behind me the way I think, you know?
That was a real fear you had?
That was a fear for a lot of guys. I know, really? I had the same conversation with Drew McIntyre recently, because there was that uncertainty. There was a bit of confidence, like, yeah, hey, I've been kicking ass all year. They're going to be behind me. But what if they're not?
You don't know, because we're in this environment, and that's what we had to do. But we're in this environment that is not the organic environment of having fans there. And that's what I truly love about our industry and what we do, is that you can put a show together on paper and you can have an idea of who's hot, who's not, who should be at the top, who shouldn't be. But once you throw that, your best laid plans, and you put them in front of a live crowd, and that live crowd is different, even in that same town, they can respond different than they would 3 months from now. So that, and that's what I really love, is that your best laid plans can completely be ruined and turned by the fans. And I'm just really grateful that for some reason people were still behind me. But that was a real, not that I was worried about it or it kept me up at night, but like you just never really know, because we're guys, we're not new, fresh guys, you know, the New Day, who are like, oh, I haven't really seen this stuff before. We've been around a long time and in a good spot. So there's just always the fear that there's that New Day fatigue or Big E fatigue.
Speak to that a little bit, because it seems as though you guys have kind of managed to stay under the radar while still being front and center for everything. For the entire run of the New Day, once you guys found your footing, obviously you guys have documented very well about the evolution that became New Day. But you guys have been, to your point, in a very good spot for a very long time. And what do you speak to that longevity?
I think a big thing really is the fact that there's a very genuine and real bond. And the power of positivity, it's the gimmick, of course. But I think it is real amongst the three of us. I think it comes from a very real place. And I think people eventually can see through manufactured chemistry, they can see through a lack of authenticity. And I think it's been important for us to be as genuine as we can be. Sure, we're still performing. You're going out there and you're not just yourself doing whatever you want. But I think we try to approach our gimmicks, our characters, in a very real way. And also we've tried our best. Obviously, there are certain parameters. It's a television show, so you can't just do whatever you want. But we've tried our best to keep our stuff fresh, whether it's gear stuff, whether it's promo stuff. But we've also been babyfaces for a very long time. And that's one of the hardest things to do, is to be a babyface for a long time, because they're not cool. We're not cool. The heels are the cool ones.
People get tired. People get tired and burned out, and you guys have somehow managed to avoid that. That's incredibly impressive. It speaks volumes to all three of your abilities.
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.